guys, I'm Ahana and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about everyone's favorite topic, failure and rejection. Now, you might be watching these videos, you might have seen my LinkedIn, and you might not realize just how much rejection and failure I've experienced already. In fact, it was after posting my last video where I talk about how to break into banking without a finance degree that people reached out to me and asked, did you really apply to over 100 internships? And the answer is yes, I really did. I realized that rejection is not just something I experienced when applying to jobs, but it's also something that if anything, I've experienced more of now working on my own startup. And as such, I think it's a super important topic to discuss. So that's on the agenda for today. I'm gonna start by sharing some of my own failures and the rejections that I've faced, just to give you a real sense that I'm not just saying this, I firsthand understand what it feels like. And after discussing that, I then want to share with you my top 5 tips for coping with rejection and failure. Because you have to experience some level of rejection to really push yourself out of your comfort zone and achieve your goals. So let's go all the way back to sixth form. At the time, it was my dream to become an astrophysicist, and I wanted to study physics at Oxford. To the extent that I'd go on tours, I would attend events, I studied a lot for the PAT test, and I'd even selected which college I wanted. And in the end, I didn't get in. I think this was the first big feeling of rejection that I'd faced because I'd always done well at school and I hadn't really experienced any kind of academic failure. I ended up going to Imperial, so I'm not going to complain too much, but ultimately I didn't get my first choice uni. But now looking back, and I know this is easy to say and everyone says it, I think it was the right decision for me. And the reason I say that is because I honestly believe that had I not been in London, I wouldn't have sought out opportunities in finance and at investment banks. And I think I would have been much more in that really academic environment and only considered physics as my career. However, being in a place where a lot of my friends were applying to other industries, that encouraged me to do the same. And after accumulating years of these internships in finance, I really built up the skills to start my own business and launch my own startup. Now I look at it, I'm far happier with how my life has turned out. And I didn't let that rejection define me. In fact, I used it to empower me and made the most out of the environment that I was in. But the rejections don't stop there, because then came the time to apply to internships and jobs. And as I just touched on, I've been rejected from so many internships that I could probably film a video on that in itself. For the sake of not making this video super long, I'm just gonna let you know that I experienced a lot of rejection when it came to my early career. And again, the rejections don't end there. There have been many, many rejections on the startup front as well. And you might be sat there thinking that, oh, she got into Y Combinator, what does she mean rejections? I'll tell you this, Y Combinator was the only accelerator acceptance we had, and we applied to a couple, including accelerators at our own university that we weren't accepted to. I do talk about this more in the How I Got Into Y Combinator video, but I am the type that applies to anything with a form. Y Combinator wasn't the only accelerator we applied to. And in fact, it wasn't just accelerators that we've been rejected from. It was also getting led on by investors. And now we look back and it's funny, but about this time last year when we were working on Quill, we had an investor from a top VC firm who was dangling a big carrot in front of us. So we spent an entire month making a business plan for him, making a really detailed tech spec, and it amounted to nothing. The easy option would have been to have become disenfranchised or given up after that, because it was a lot of hard work and effort that we put in. Don't think that these were insignificant rejections. We put in a lot of time and a lot of effort and made sacrifices on other fronts to try and push certain things forward. And ultimately, it fell through and nothing happened. But had we let that situation define us and stop us from applying, then the opportunity with Y Combinator would have never happened. And I wouldn't be sat here talking to you today and sharing my startup journey. So on that note, let's get into sharing my 5 top tips for dealing with rejection. Number 1, don't attach happiness to factors that are beyond your control. I think I first heard this from Justin Kahn, who's a former YC partner, and it really, really resonated with me and made so much sense. I think this ethos speaks to so many different facets of life, but in particular, when it comes to applying for things and putting yourself out there, the only things that you can control are your actions. And of course, it sounds silly and obvious, but You can't control how other people are going to react. You can't control how an employer is going to view your CV. What you can control is the CV that you submit, or the application that you submit, and what side of yourself that you put forward. And the way I see it, dealing with regret is worse than dealing with rejection, because regret is within your control. People end up regretting actions they didn't take. But people get over rejection, and the reason being is because it's not within your control. If an external entity or somebody else rejects you, that's on them, but you know in your heart that you tried and it didn't work out, and that's okay. On that point, the second tip I have for dealing with rejection is to acknowledge your emotions. It's okay to feel down, and in fact, this is the normal reaction to rejection. In fact, pretending not to care or genuinely not caring probably aren't the healthiest ways of dealing with rejection, because if you can acknowledge in the first place that you wanted this opportunity and it didn't work out, you can use it to empower you and move forwards and not hold a bitterness towards the experience. And I just want to say, I totally understand how awful it feels. You get that sinking feeling in your gut, you feel anger, you feel like you've poured time into something and it amounted to nothing. But that's not true. I'm yet to meet a single person who didn't learn at least something from their experience with rejection. And in fact, on the point of learning, it's those who don't learn from their rejections who, unfortunately, will keep getting rejected over and over and over, because if you don't reflect on it, you'll keep making the same mistakes, and ultimately, if you're going to put the time in to apply for more jobs or more opportunities, then you might as well do everything in your power to maximize your chances of success. And one of those factors is learning from your past experiences. It doesn't do you any favors if you just blame it on the company or don't acknowledge your feelings about it, because it doesn't matter to the company, it's you who this affects. And there are certain ways that you can deal with it that will help you more next time than just shutting off your emotions and not thinking about it at all. My third tip is, don't let rejection define you. And what I mean by that is, don't allow a single rejection to allow you to make sweeping generalizations about a firm or about an industry. Similar to the last point about bitterness, if you allow these rejections to result in very strong views about a particular topic based on a single bad experience, you're really going to struggle when it comes to pursuing new opportunities if your view is tainted by a single bad experience. And I understand that when you get multiple rejections, as I certainly did when it came to applying for summer internships and accelerators or speaking to investors about my startup, it's only human to start pattern matching and wondering if maybe this isn't right, maybe everyone in this industry is like this, maybe no one will take a chance on me. But the truth is, you just need one person to take a chance on you. My fourth tip is to try to change your mindset about rejection. Instead of viewing it as you are the problem and you are a failure, view it as you are pushing yourself out of your comfort zone and seeking new opportunities. People who aren't seeking any new opportunities or pushing themselves to grow, perhaps they won't face any rejection. But you need to ask yourself if that's really what you want, and it's totally fine if that is what you want. Different people have different priorities in life, and there is no right way to lead your life. But if you are looking to succeed in highly competitive industries like finance or entrepreneurship, the only way you will succeed is by pushing yourself out of your comfort zone. And my fifth and final tip is to hedge your risks. I'm gonna make a Love Island reference. Professionally, this translates to applying for more opportunities. For those of you who might also be watching the latest season of Love Island, you might be familiar with the term of not putting all of your eggs in one basket. And whilst I wouldn't advise that romantically, I do actually think that in a professional setting, that probably is a good idea, because generally speaking, you don't owe employer A any more than you owe employer B, especially if these opportunities require a very similar application process. You don't have to do that much more work to submit another application. But as I said, it's just about finding that one person to take a chance on you, and the more opportunities that you create, the more luck will come to you. I mentioned this more at the beginning, but somebody brought this topic up to me in relation to my last video on summer internships and banking rejections. But actually, I think rejection is even more prevalent in my job now as an entrepreneur I have a joke with my friends that I'm a professional beggar. And the reason I say that is because it is my job to constantly ask people for things to create opportunities. In a job like this, you have to be able to ask your friends to download your app. You need to be able to ask customers for feedback. You need to ask influencers to work with you. You need to ask journalists to cover your story. And then when you get to fundraising, you need to ask people for money. And none of these are inherently fun activities, as there's always the chance that somebody says no. But the value that just one person saying yes will bring will outweigh all the rejections that you face. To really make it very clear to you the scale of rejection that I face on a daily basis in this job, I'll give you a recent example. So right now we're in the phase where every single user matters, and we've set ourselves a 5,000 user target for this month, which, by the way, is 10 times more than we achieved last month. But I was going through all of the connections and contacts that I have, and I had a group of about 10 friends back in primary school who I haven't spoken to for about 10 years. Of course, I'd already asked all the people that were much closer to me, but I really needed the numbers. I'd kind of been putting off messaging these friends because it's not the most comfortable thing to do after 10 years of losing contact to be like, hey, download my app. But it's a question of priorities. And right now my priority is my company and more specifically, user numbers for this month. The potential upside of even one of these friends saying yes outweighs the bad feeling of them potentially ignoring me. So in the end, I suck it up and I message all 10 of these girls. 6 of them respond. In fact, 2 of them even made posts on Facebook helping share it, which was extremely heartwarming because, as I said, I'd lost touch with these friends, and the fact that they were willing to go above and beyond to support me really, really meant a lot. And that's what I mean about creating opportunities. Had I not messaged them, I wouldn't have known that they'd been able to share this. So not only did they download it, they got more people to download it. But only 6 of them responded. The other 4 saw my messages and ignored me. I won't lie, wasn't super happy. It's not a great feeling to be ignored. But at the end of the day, as I said, my priorities lie with my company. And in fact, if I hadn't reached out to them at all, if I was too scared of the rejection, we'd have got 0 users from that group of people. So all in all, I'd say it was a success, but that only happened because I got over my fear of failure and of rejection, and I reached out. So that's all for this video. I hope me sharing some of my failures and rejections has helped you to realize that it is absolutely normal and everyone goes through it. You have to remember that with social media, especially platforms like LinkedIn, people are only sharing the highlights. And I will hold my hands up and say that I'm absolutely guilty of doing that too. On my profile, I haven't listed every rejection I've faced, and if I did, it would probably be way too long for anyone to read anyway. But the good news is that you just need one person to take a chance on you and say yes. I truly believe that the more resilient and conscientious that you are, the more opportunities will come your way. And you mustn't let failure or disappointment or rejection stop you from pursuing new opportunities. And I think I'm gonna leave it there. Please like this video if you enjoyed it and subscribe to my channel for more careers and startups related content. That's all for this one, and I'll see you in the next one.